listen to the sound of restoration. This is the sound of restoration.
Let's go to Psalms 107.
Asiyeke esihlabelelweni selikhulu nesikhombisa.
We are going to read verse 23 and 24.
Sitawufunda ke verse lemashumi lamabili nakuthathu namashumi lamabili nesine.
Let's read it in Siswati.
Asiqale ngeSiswati.
Labanye babehla benyuka ngemikhumbi elwandle babephila ngekuheba bayibona imisebenzi yasimakathe netimangaliso takhe ekujulweni kwalo.
Praise God. Thank you. In the New King James, it says those who go down to the sea in ships, who do business on great waters, they see the works of the Lord and his wonders in the deep. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Well, Batandekayo, there is such an obsession in our hearts. It's to experience God. We have so much hunger and desire for his presence. To see his move. And have wonderful encounters with him. There is that obsession in our hearts. And may it be imparted to you. Just be hungry for God. Just desire more of God. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Once again, may this spirit be imparted in your hearts in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So what we will be speaking on this morning, it is in relation to that. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, those who go down to the sea in ships, who do business in great waters. Somebody say great waters. Say it again, great waters. They see the works of the Lord and the wonders and his wonders in the deep.
Mm.
Somebody say in the deep. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brethren, there are great waters in God. There are depths in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Lord is calling us. Calling us to the deep. Calling us to great waters. Glory to God. The deep in God is the safest place.
Amen.
I want us to desire this morning
and
hunger for the depths in God. We want to be in the safe place. We want to be in the place of production. It is in the deep. It is in the great waters. Lift our hands to King Jesus
Christ.
Not the shallow. Refuse to be in the shallow today. You remember when the Lord Jesus told
a parable about the sower.
Yakubula Jesu nayakhuluma ngemfanekiso walohlanyelako.
He spoke about seeds which fell to a rocky place.
Wakukhuluma ngedinga enhlanyelo lewela emajwaleni.
Can you project that scripture in the New Living Translation?
Ngela ukuthi uveteke lombhalo laphaya.
He says, these seeds which fell to a rocky place, it could not produce anything because soon it dried, it withered. The reason is it was shallow, it was not in the deep. Matthew chapter 13. Other seeds fell on shallow soil, and with underlying rock, the seeds sprouted quickly because the soil was shallow. Verse 6. But the plants soon wilted under the hot sun, and since they did not have deep roots, they died. Brethren,
Bazalwane,
it's dangerous to be in the shallow, but it is safe to be in the deep. Look at the seeds which fell to a shallow place. It quickly withered. It quickly died and never produced anything. But I've come to say, let us launch into the deep. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us launch into great waters. In God,
Bazalwane,
there are depths in God. There are great waters in God. The word of the Lord shows us that indeed there are depths in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the Bible, we read about the journey of the children of
Israel.
I like illustrating with that journey. When we speak about our Christian walk, they were in Egypt. But then God liberated them from Egypt. Under the leadership of Moses, they moved all the way to Kadesh Barnea. But that was not the end of the road, because there are depths in God. God raised Joshua. He took over the leadership. He led them to the promised land, Canaan. But still, let me tell you, that was not the end of the journey, because there are dimensions in God. There are depths in God. Tell your neighbor and say, where you are, it's not the end of the road. Glory to God.
Amen.
We give God praise for leading us till this far. But we understand through scripture that there are depths in God which are waiting for us. There are uncharted waters. There are uncharted grounds which are waiting for us deep down in God. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
So after the leadership of Joshua, who took them to the promised land, Canaan, after many years, God raised David. And David took them to Mount Zion. Actually, Mount Zion was the ultimate mountain where God wanted them. There is a place, Bazalwane, where God wants us to be. Let us not be content just doing business in the shallows. The Bible says, where we have read this morning, those who go down to the sea, in ships
who
do business on great waters.
So,
in other words, there are people who do business in great waters. I want you to hate the shallow today. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
I want you to hate the shallow today. But I want you to go deep to the great waters. The psalmist say here, those who do business in great waters, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
They see the works of God. They see his wonders in the deep. In other words, the works of God are in the deep. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The wonders of God, they are in the deep. In the great waters. Somebody say, take me deeper, Lord.
Take me deeper, Lord.
I'm also saying, take me deeper.
Whoa.
Take me deeper, Lord. Take me deeper, Lord. Take me deeper, Lord. Take me deeper, Lord. I pray even for life restoration. Take us deeper, Lord. And Bazalwane, the way I hate the shallow. Because sometimes the shallow places, they embarrass us. We find ourselves in shame. Because it will find its way to manifest that, oh, this one is in the shallow. Remember the sons of Sceva. How they were embarrassed by demons. Because they were in the shallow. They did not know Jesus. So they are trying to cast out devils. They say, in the name of Jesus, whom Paul preaches, come out. The demons are saying, Paul, we know. Jesus, we know. Who are you? This young man were not known in the world of the Spirit because they were in the shallow. Maybe not even in the shallow. They were just not in the sea at all. And demons embarrassed them. We don't want any embarrassment, Bazalwane. It happens. That shallowness tends to manifest. But today, we are launching into the deep. We are launching into the deep to see the works of the Lord. To see the wonders in the deep. Somebody say, take me deeper, Lord. Glory to God. Take me deeper, Lord. Take me deeper, Lord. Take me deeper, Lord. In the name of Jesus. I don't want to remain in the shallow. Oh my God. There are men and women in Scripture who were deep in God. Who were in the great waters. Remember Enoch. The Bible says Enoch walked with God. Like it in the Amplified. It says he walked in habitual fellowship with God. Let there arise a people here who will walk in habitual fellowship with God. In other words, Enoch was deep in God. The relationship of Enoch with God was so deep. It was not a shallow relationship. The Bible says this man did not die. Can you imagine this? He is walking with God in habitual fellowship. point when God just simply took him. He did not die. It speaks about the depth of the relationship.
Yo. Hallelujah.
When the writer of Hebrews testifies about him, he tells us that Enoch walked with God, and he did not see death, for God took him. He had this testimony that he pleased God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is a deep relationship. When God is pleased about your life, remember the Lord Jesus Christ. Even before he performed a single miracle, the Father said, "You are my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." Let me speak to you, young people. Amen.
That your relationship with
some
God,
at this side, let it not be shallow. Let it not be shallow. You are in danger when your relationship with God is shallow. Somebody say, "Take me deeper, Lord." Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You need a deep relationship with God. Walk in habitual fellowship with God.
Hallelujah.
And have a testimony that you pleased God. Bible says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. That is why this man Enoch is actually a man of faith. Having touched on Enoch, I remember Abraham now. Because Abraham was called a friend of God. Amen.
Amen.
He was called a friend of God. That is how close Abraham was with God. That God was not ashamed to call him my friend. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The man was deep relationship with God. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the Bible says this morning, those who go to the sea in ships, who do business in great waters, hallelujah, they see the works of God. And they see his wonders in the deep. Amen.
Hallelujah.
It looks like I'm not going to end preaching these days without touching on Moses.
Amen. Amen.
A man who was deep, he was able to see the wonders of God because he was in the deep.
Amen.
Remember how he fellowshipped with the Lord, the encounters he had with the Lord. When he's praying on the mountain, he went into the cloud.
Amen.
Some of the Israelites, they were down there. They were not even on the mountain. Maybe at least Joshua was on the mountain. But Moses was not just on Mount Sinai, but he went deep into the cloud. That is where God wants us, Bazalwane, to be in the deep. Glory to God.
Amen.
That is where wonders are. That is where the great works of the Lord are. In the deep. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses was in the deep.
Amen.
In Jeremiah, it must be chapter 15. Amen. Verse number 1.
Moses
is mentioned with Samuel as man who could stand before God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me read it to you. It says, then the Lord said to me, though Moses and Samuel stood interceding for them before me, yet my mind could not be turned with favor towards these people, Judah. Send them out of my sight and let them go.
Jeremiah
is trying to pray for the nation of Israel. In the previous chapter, God says, don't pray for these people. I'm not going to change my mind. He even says now, even if Moses
or Samuel
can stand before me and make intercession for the people, I will not change my mind. If there is a thing that Moses is known for, he was a great intercessor. He could pray until God changes his mind. Doesn't it sound strange, Bazalwane, that God can change his mind? There was a time when the children of Israel sit before God and God decided that I will destroy these people and build a new nation from you, Moses. But Moses said, no.
You
should not happen like that. You cannot destroy your people in the wilderness. What will the Egyptians say? This man could stand before God and pray, amen, make intercession until God changes his mind, like it happened on this particular day. God changed his mind. We need people like that who can stand before God, but it demands that you go into the deep in God. These are the people who God hears when they pray.
Amen.
These are the people who can change the mind of God by their intercession. Bazalwane, it will really depend on our depth in God, how effective we are going to be. But we must be effective. But our depth will determine if really are we going to cast the devils. If really our songs will change people. If really we can stop diseases, it will depend on our
death.
I remember David himself.
David,
a man was deep in God. I mean, just by mere playing a harp, Saul could be relieved from evil spirits from the Lord.
Amen.
Just by mere playing. No, he's not singing. He's not preaching. He's not praying. But he's simply playing. But as he plays, there is an effect such that Saul is relieved from the evil spirit, because the man is deep. Somebody say, take me deeper, Lord.
Take me deeper, Lord.
How much we need even in our time. Effective musicians. There are many people who sing, but they are just entertainers. Some have got beautiful voices. But I tell you, when they sing, it will only end in our ears. We can only dance to the beat. But the musicians that we are praying for, people who will play like David, and bring an effect
when
they sing, demons cannot stand in their music, cannot stand in their presence. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
To church, all the musicians in the house,
go
deep in God. When you are deep in God,
Now sengu chuleni kulungu.
Your music will be something else.
Shabele la wako kutaba ngogunye.
Your music will be something else.
Shabele la wako kutaba ngogunye.
I tell you, your music will be something else. Not only music ministry, but every ministry.
The
death of the person executing the ministry will determine the effectiveness. When Peter preached on the day of Pentecost, the Bible says the people were pricked in their hearts. Was not the eloquence of the man.
No.
Was not the education of the man. But the man was deep in God. Such that when he uttered words, it was more like uttering fire. It was more like uttering a sword that would pierce the heart of a man. Glory to Jesus. Somebody say, take me deeper, Lord.
Take me deeper, Lord.
Let's not be content to be in the shallow.
Let's
not be content to be in the shallow. And one thing, Bazalwane, we acknowledge. It is that the church is in trouble.
And
this issue. Unanswered prayers. I know you will try to be a bit religious in this. But if I can sit down with you, you have a serious challenge of prayers which are not answered. That the challenge is not with God. No, it's not with God. But the challenge can only be with us. That is why we pray prayers and we don't see an answer. God is ready to answer
anything.
But I believe today, one of the things that will keep this problem, it is when we go deep in God. When we pray in great water, our prayers will be effective. Even prayer of a righteous man availeth
much.
Glory to God. The Amplified says it makes tremendous power available. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then we are given an example. The example of Elijah.
Elijah was
a man like us.
Elijah,
but he prayed that it doesn't rain for a space of 3 years and 6 months. And it did not rain. And there was no dew. He prayed again that rain may come. And indeed rain came. But it should challenge us, Bazalwane, that Elijah was a man like us. Then what is the difference?
Why
are the prayers of Elijah heard in our prayers? It's the death.
It's the death.
Why are the prayers of Elijah heard in our prayers? Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
But today, we want to make a pledge in our hearts
that
we are launching into the deep to see the works of God and to see his wonders in the deep. Hallelujah. Remember, Bazalwane, Jesus comes by the sea. He found Peter fishing with the others. Actually, they were not fishing. They were washing their nets. In other words, they have already retired now. Jesus borrows the boat of Peter. And then he speaks to the people. Then after that, he gives an instruction. He says, launch into the deep. Somebody tell your neighbor, launch into the deep. Launch
into the deep for a great catch. This sounds like these people have been fishing in the shallow. It seems. It seems they were busy in the shallow. Let me tell you, in the shallow, you catch nothing. In the shallow, you can toil the whole night. Because it's in the shallow.
No,
the Lord Jesus Christ doesn't change a lot of things. He only says to them, launch into the deep for a great catch.
My
God, hallelujah. Peter says, Master, we have toiled the whole night and we did not catch anything. Then he continues and says, but at your word, we will throw down the net. At your word, hear the word of the Lord. Launch into the deep for a great catch. In your prayer, launch into the deep. In your relationship with God, launch into the deep. Hallelujah. Launch into the deep. I promise you that in the deep there shall be a great catch. After they had launched into the deep and threw their nets, the Bible says they caught a lot of fish.
Amen.
And their nets began to break. They had to signal even other fellows to come and help them. That is what you get when you are in the deep. Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
In Ezekiel chapter 47,
Ezekiel,
the Bible tells us that Ezekiel was in a vision and he saw the Millennium Temple and the Jerusalem city. Amen. He sees a river, and it's a river of life. Because at the banks of this river, there were trees with fruits. And the Bible says the fruits are for food, and the leaves are for the healing of the nations. Wherever this river goes, there is life. Now, Ezekiel the prophet is led by this man to this river holding a measuring line. He first measures 1,000 cubits, and when he measured 1,000, the water were ankle deep. Somebody say ankle deep. You see, when water is at ankle deep, you can still walk. You are still in control. But then the guide measured another 1,000, and the waters were now knee-deep. After that, he measured another 1,000. The water was waist deep. Eventually, after measuring another 1,000, it was deep now. It was great waters now. In other words, now they were submerged under the water. He says, it was a river that you could never cross, but a river which you had to swim. Swallowed in the river, submerged in the river. When you are in great waters, you don't have even control over yourself. The water is controlling you, taking you where it wants to take you. May the river of life take us to where it pleases. May the river of life control us, Bazalwane. Maybe
it's not much that you are in need of. It is just for you to go into the deep. Some of the problems that you are facing, you don't even need counselors to talk to. All that you needed was just to go deep a little bit. Because as you go deep, you get dissolved. Everything that was a mountain before you
melts.
I'm reminded of a scripture.
In the book of Genesis chapter 7.
In the book of Genesis chapter 7.
In verse number 11.
In verse number 11.
The Bible says. The fountains of the deep broke up. Fountains of the deep. They broke up. Let's read it. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, the 17th day of the month, on that day, all the fountains of the great deep were broken up. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Fountains of the great deep, they broke
up.
Let me submit to you, church, that the fountains of the river of life, they have broken over us to submerge us. Hallelujah. The Bible says it rained on that day, actually for 40 days, and the mountains fountains of the great deep have broken up. In the time of revival, what actually is happening?
That the water rises. Yes, the water rises.
That is what is happening. In revival, the fountains of the great deep, they break up. And heavens open. We receive abundant rain. And we shall be submerged under the rain.
I now declare in the name
that
of
all
Jesus,
mountains before you be swallowed,
that all don't get into our pambi wako
by the river of life. In the name of Jesus Christ. The mountains which were obstructing your view, may they be swallowed in the name of Jesus Christ. The mountains which were a hindrance such that you couldn't reach your destiny, you are struggling,
we are
not able to reach your destiny. But in the mercies of the living God, may all those mountains be swallowed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
So, Ezekiel was led until they came to deep waters. But let me come back to this man who is guiding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because Ezekiel is not alone. But Ezekiel has a guide.
Ezekiel
listen. If you want to go deep, Ezekiel was not alone as he was shattering those waters. But there was somebody who is carrying a measuring line. And, listen,
bazalwane. As I have already said, it's uncharted waters. Listen, if it's uncharted waters, it means you don't know. The reason
Ezekiel
needs a guide. It is because these waters are uncharted. He has never been there. He does not know. Then the Lord Jesus says, I still have many things to tell you. I still have many dimensions to show you. There are still many uncharted places which are in God which you don't know. So, but the thing is, I cannot tell you now, but when He, the Spirit of Truth, comes, He will guide you into all truth. In other words, He will lead you to the places you have never been. Listen, Mazalwan, it's not a pastor who leads you to uncharted waters. It's not your counselor who leads you to uncharted waters. But the guide who leads us to uncharted waters, it is the Lord God, the Holy Spirit. He knows the way. Oh, hallelujah. The Bible says, we do not know even how to pray. But with the Holy Spirit, we can pray prayers that we couldn't pray before. Or because the Holy Spirit knows the mind of the Spirit. He knows the depths in God. When you pray, led by the Holy Spirit, you can pray prayers you did not plan. Prayers you did not think about. But if you only pray in the mind, you are limited to what you can think only. But when you are led by the Spirit, you touch places which you couldn't touch on your own. The Holy Spirit. How many love the Holy Ghost? Our guide.
Hallelujah.
We cannot afford to walk on our own. We've never been this way before. We need the Holy Spirit to lead us into dimensions we don't know. Leading us to all truth. So wave our hands to King Jesus.
Hallelujah. Today, brethren, deep calleth unto deep.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Deep
calleth unto deep. But there is someone who's taking us to the depths.
The Holy Spirit.
When
Paul writes about him, it's 2 Corinthians chapter number 2. Verse 9 and 10. He says, that which no eye has seen, that which no ear has heard, even the things which have not entered the heart of man. It means the places we don't know, the depths we don't know in God. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Then Paul says, when he speaks about the Holy Spirit, these things which you don't know, which you haven't seen, which you haven't
heard,
you haven't thought about, they are revealed by the Spirit. They are revealed by the Spirit. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse number 9 and 10. Hallelujah. Listen. But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. Verse number 10. But God has revealed them to us through the Holy Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things. Yes, the deep things of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just like that last part.
Amen.
That the Holy Spirit
searches all things and even the deep things of God. There are deep things in God, but they can be searched by the Spirit, and He can guide you into those things and touch what you could not touch before. Walk where you could not walk before. Do what you could not do before. The Holy Spirit is able to search the deep things in God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's our guide, bazalwane, to the deep things. We are not just singing
going to give us even songs that have not been sung. Hallelujah.
So wave our hands to Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Palms the down that have sit palms the Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Then the psalmist, chapter number 42. We are about to close now.
Says now, Tandaza March.
Says,
Uti,
the deep,
Uti, Uchula,
calls unto deep.
Uchula, Bitakchu.
It's amazing how God can change something negative to a positive thing. Because the psalmist is crying here about the deep, about the torrents, about billows of challenges.
Amen.
Praise God. But God is turning that thing around. He says these depths, amen, are depths of revival, are depths of glory, are depths of the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What is it saying? There is the depth in God, but there is depth in us. And depth in us is in our hearts. It must be our hearts who call unto the deep in God. When we cry to God with all our hearts, crying for the depth in God, I tell you the truth, we will find that those places in God. Actually, it is God first who cries to our deep. He says, my son, give me your heart. And then we must also cry and say, Lord, give us your heart. Give us your death, O God. We want you. We want your glory. We want your presence. The deep cries unto deep.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
the Lord Jesus Christ,
Bazalwane,
is the epitome of doing business in the deep.
He
is a perfect example.
Ooh.
We read last Sunday that he is in the bosom of the Father. He's in the deep. Look at his life. Look how he walked on earth. His position is in the deep. When we are in the deep, the things which the Lord Jesus did, we can also do.
Hallelujah.
Because Jesus, clearly he is the epitome of what we are talking about. We can talk about Moses. We can talk about Abraham. We can talk about
Enoch.
But the main man,
the Lord
Jesus Christ. He's in the deep of God. He could walk and live the life he lived. He's in the deep. I want us to pray, Bazalwane.